So in this question, what is happening? A train after traveling 50 kilometers. So imagine this is like the distance of 50 kilometers. Meets with an accident and travel at 3/4 its regular speed. Hereafter and hence reaches its destination 35 minutes late. Had the accident occurred 30 kilometers further. So what happens? There is some accident here and then it's traveled by 3/4 of its speed. And then it reaches 35 minutes late. 35 minutes late. Now, there is another question. If this same accident happened 30 kilometers further, like this was 30. So again, after this will be same, it will travel after of its 3/4 its regular speed, and it reaches 23 minutes late. So earlier it was 35 minutes late, now it's reaching 23 minutes late, right? This is the question. So why I am discussing this question is because this is very frequently asked in any exam, like whatever be the level. It's not only based on CAT or maybe SNAP or maybe SSC or maybe it can come in banks. So this question can be tricky if someone don't know, you know, the logic and they try to solve it using equations. But there's no need to do that. This was the accident point. The only difference which is happening, the thing is this gap, right? So what is happening? The speed is 3/4. The time becomes what? 4/3 rate, like ratio. Okay, that you must have known and understood if you must have read my post on that TSD post which was posted earlier. So what happens if you see the time difference? It was 35 minutes late and it's 23 minutes. So you got the difference 12 minutes. So if you see the ratio of time was 4:3, so you just need to see the difference between them is 4x and 3x is x, which is equal to 12. So if you multiply them, because what is the gap which you need is 12. So 4 × 12 is 48 and 3 × 12 is 36. So this is your time. So earlier it was taking, you know, 36 minutes. Now it's taking 48 minutes, right? Because earlier the speed was more, it got reduced. So when more speed is there, time will be less. And then is, so that's, this is the first case. And this is the second case, the time for that. That's very normal to observe. So having obtained the, you know, the time, you can do what? The distance was 30. So 30 by 36 by 60, because you have to deal in kilometer per hour, that is given in minutes. So you will, so you got, if you do this, so 50 kilometers per hour. So this is the initial speed. So from this you can get the other speed also. Just do 3/4 or something, and that's not the question asked here. It's asking the regular speed. So you saw, I have taken a lot of time to explain you, but you saw how easy it becomes when you understand the concept, and you just take the time difference, see the time gap, because the speed ratio is inversely proportional to the time ratio, got the difference, and then calculated using distance by time, which you got speed here, right? So no problem in solving these kind of questions, and these occur very frequently in exam, because whenever there has to be TSD, they will be asking something on he is late by 5 minutes or 2 minutes and something like that. So this part is covered. Now we'll see total distance traveled by train. Now the second part is find the total distance traveled by the train. So these two are really different question, because a lot of time people solve the speed and try to get the distance. That is not really required. You can do it directly. So how to do it directly, we'll show you. So first, what happens? To be late by, if you see the difference, it was how much? 7 + 5, so 12. So to be late by 12 minutes, distance travel was, so distance travel is 30 kilometers, right? Because he got late by whatever, he traveled 30 kilometers. To be late by 1 minute is just 30 by 12, okay? And to be late by 35, you know, minutes, because that was our initial thing, so it will be 30 by 12 × 35. So which you get? which is 87.5 kilometers, right? So this was being whatever the calculation was being done for was this part, right? You forgot the 50 kilometers, which was not necessary. Sometimes they don't give you this 50 kilometers, they directly give you this situation and they ask you, but really here we are missing out with 50 plus 87.5. So if you do this, you will get 137.5, I think, yeah. So 137.5 is our total kilometers. So you saw in both of these questions, sometimes in exam what they ask, they give you this current scenario and they ask you the distance. Sometimes they ask you the speed. So what, when you need to find the distance, just do how many minutes it was late and it traveled, you know, this part 30 kilometers, just do 1 minute and then, you know, multiply by the initial thing. You have to understand this because it's very simple and you don't need to spend a lot of time in solving this. Thank you.